Assalamualaikum and good day. Today, kita akan belajar chapter terakhir, which is chapter 6, statistically indeterminate structure. Beams that have more than one span and they are continuous throughout their length are known as continuous beam. As what you see in the diagram here, this is the example of continuous beam because of it have more than one span. Two span and more lah. They are commonly encountered in aircraft, bridges, buildings, pipelines and various other kind of specialized structures. Continuous beams are statically indeterminate. As what you have learned in part 1, you learn about statically determinate, which means only one span beam. So ini boleh didetermine secara static. Static tu apa? Yang you kira reaction tu lah, you dapatkan RA, RB. That is statically determinate. But macam continuous beam ni, this is what we call statically indeterminate. You cannot find the reaction just using the way macam you dapatkan masa you kira for one span beam. You have to use additional method ataupun additional calculation so that baru you akan dapatkan reaction. That's why nama dia statically indeterminate. Statically indeterminate ni not only for beams, they also what we call as portal frame. Portal frame not include in your syllabus eh, a connection like this. Method to analyze indeterminate structure, we have force methods, slope deflection, moment distribution and three moment equation. We have four methods. For your syllabus, what we will learn is we're going to do the moment distribution method to find the reaction eh. This method was developed by Professor Hardy Cross in 1932. This method solved for the joint moment in continuous beams and rigid frame by successive approximation. The principles is, first there is sign convention. What you must remember and you must stick to it, clockwise moment acts on member is positive, while counterclockwise moment act on member, we consider it as negative. Like what you have learned masa you buat reaction, because kita ada like making like assumption and whatever clockwise kita akan anggap dia positive and counterclockwise for moment we going to consider as negative. We have K. So K ni adalah stiffness factor eh. K equal to 4EI over L when far N is fixed, and K equal to 3EI over L when far N is rolled or pin supported. For example here, okay, you have beam like this. Roller fixed and this is statically indeterminate beam because it have more than one span. So, two span. Eh? For this beam, AB, because far end, meaning the outside support is fixed support. Therefore, this beam, the stiffness factor is 4EI over L. While for beam BC, the far end is a roller because the one yang far end tu yang dekat luar, yang A ke B, you tengok dekat A and B ke C, you tengok dekat C. Jadi this is roller. Therefore, the stiffness factor is 3EI over L. Another principle is fixed end moment FEM. Means this one depends on the moment acting on top of the beam. Eh? Berapa banyak being transferred to the beam. If it's point load, the way we kita akan kira, kita akan pakai formula PAB square over L square. For beam AB, P is the load, A is this length, and this one adalah B. Square kan dia and divide by L square, which means the length of the beam is L lah. Let's say UDL, for example, I draw here for beam BC. WL square over 12, which means that the L should be the length of the beam itself. And W is berapa kilonewton per meter, the value of UDL. Then you masukkan dalam this formula. That will be all for this recorded video. I will continue during the next class.